Hello there. Very nice to see you. A pleasure to have your company as always today.
Yeah, and we've got a packed show for you. Hope you can stay with us till 12:30 because we've brought a cautionary tale actually today. After her marriage broke down, Alison Peters, she went looking for love a second time around and she thought she'd found it on the internet.
However, she met a man who conned her out of £125,000 and left her living in a caravan.
Well, Alison's telling us her story a bit later. Also this morning, the former editor of Lads Mag Loaded says being a stay-at-home dad nearly killed his sex life. But that's him there. But Tim Atkinson, he had a different experience. He says his was totally different. He can't rate bringing up baby highly enough.
Well, it's
that's
a tough job. Whoever does it.
It's a very tough job.
Has to be said. If you are a stay-at-home mum, dad or whatever, look who'll be entertaining you throughout the show. Morning.
Well, we've got the big debate this morning. Should dad stay at home and look after the kids? Two men who did, very differing opinions on what it was like. Before we talk to them, though, it's prize draw time for you. Your chance to win a VIP villa holiday, $35,000 in cash. Jeff Brazier has all the details.
He was a stressed-out TV presenter in search of a summer of luxury, and he found it here. At the VIP Villa, there will be sunsets, there will be sunbathing, and there will be a whole lot of snorkeling. Jeff Brazier is
having the time of my life, and you could be too, here in marvellous Menorca.
Yes, your family of six could soon be the stars of your own blockbusting seven-night holiday. Courtesy of Solmar Villas, you'll be jetting off here to the A-list getaway that is Villa Maitreya and enjoy all the mod cons, including your own private pool.
And that's not all. Tell them, voiceover guy.
Just when you thought it wasn't safe to look at your bank balance, we bring you £35,000 in tax-free cash.
For your chance to win, all you need to do is
call 09041 61 99 99. Calls cost no more than £1.54 from BT Landlines. Calls from other networks may be higher, and from mobiles will be considerably more. Text prize to 63335. Text costs £1.50 plus one standard network rate message. You can also enter for free at ITV.com. Entrance must be 18 or over. Entries made after lines close at 5 p.m. on Sunday, the 2nd of September, will not be counted but may still be charged.
Now, according to a recent research, one in seven fathers is now a stay-at-home dad. Two men have both taken on this role, our former Lads Mag editor, Martin Daubney, and his experiences proved, disturbing for him, that he wrote an article on the whole issue. However, Tim Atkinson, who's beside him here, of a dad of three, couldn't disagree more. He says he stayed at home and raised the family for 3 years now, and he's loving it. So, Ruth, we are debating.
The big debate is, are dads designed to stay at home and bring up the kids? So I presume, Martin, you'd say no, you're not. You didn't like it, you weren't very good at it.
I think it's an incredibly worthwhile thing to do, and I think, given the chance, all men should give it a go. Lots of men don't get the choice in this, of course. What we're seeing is, you know, redundancies, and they're kind of foisted into it, and they don't have the skills to sort of cope. This is something that women have faced for generations, and men are just finding increasingly now. You know, they're thrown in at the deep end. I used to edit the magazine. I was, like, doing 60 hours a week. I would never see Sunny at bedtime. I'd never see bath time. I had no life balance when the opportunity came to leave Loaded. Become a stay-at-home dad on a full-time basis. I was swept along by the romance of it.
So did you think at that point, piece of cake compared to what I've been doing, being the editor of a magazine, stay at home
I was in charge of teams of 35, multi-million pound budgets, you know, sort of deadlines all the time. I thought, well, how hard can this be? And the answer is extremely hard, and harder than anything I ever did before. And after six long months of trying it, I think I just admitted my own shortfalls, and that was, you know, I don't think I had the skills to do it. I wasn't patient and tolerant enough. And, you know, I really missed working.
That's a man thing. You think that's programmed into men to be like that, or most men?
I think it is, and I think, furthermore, I think the problem is men have an inability to reach out and ask for help because, you know, men don't like failure, particularly if you work in an environment where you're gauged on success or failure, like I was, you know, a very sort of cut-and-thrust professional world. And asking, you know, your partner for help, you think, well, I can't do that because my partner had been a stay-at-home mum for a year and she coped, so why can't I cope? So,
was she judgmental?
No, she wasn't. She was supportive, but I became a complete overbearing bore, and I was just arguing with her all the time. Because after being at home all day, sort of covered in vomit and sort of, you know, padding around the place in jogging bottoms and generally feeling like... It's actually quite, like, loaded in a way, but I moved on. You know, you didn't feel good about yourself. The loneliness was massive. Mm. Stay-at-home mums know this. You know, you get depressed. But a further problem I found was when I attempted to integrate into the world of groups... I was the only man there.
And what, baby toddler groups?
That yeah, kind of the sort of singing groups. So you'd go along and rattle tambourines, and it's all very worthwhile, but really hard work for a man.
Women. Well. Listen, it's pretty hard work for a woman.
It is.
We
yeah.
did all that, wheels on the bus. But I'm presuming, Martin, Tim, you haven't found it difficult. You said so. Are
well,
you loving
no, I mean,
all that wheels on the bus go round and round?
I love it. I love all that sort of thing. But I mean, I do agree that it is terrifically difficult. But I think Martin hit the nail on the head when. He said about not going into it prepared. You know, you just expect to be given a baby in the maternity suite and know what to do with it. Well, you absolutely can't. And I suppose I was lucky because
well,
I've got an older daughter.
Would that not apply to women as well?
Absolutely, yeah. Absolutely it does. There's a stack of literature available for mums and dads. And I think you've just got to do your homework. You've got to go into it with your eyes wide open, know what you're doing and expect... to be frazzled and have the vomit-stained clothes and the scrambled egg down your shirt.
Do you slob around, as you said, in your tracksuit?
Well, I kind of try not to. I mean, my two are reasonably house-trained now, so it's not as messy as it once was.
But you've got three children, so how many of them have you stayed at home?
Well, my elder daughter, Sally, went to nursery at the age of 6 months because my wife and I had careers to pursue, and that was fine. And I have no regret about her time at nursery. It suited her perfectly well, and it's socialised her and integrated her and made her the kind of teenager she is today. Lovely girl. When Charlie came along 4 years ago, I must admit there was a tinge of regret. I kind of, I'd always missed out a little bit on some of the milestone stages in her infancy. You know, she took her first steps at nursery, witnessed by the nursery teachers, and she'd blown out the candles on her birthday cakes, you know, from the age of one to four during her time at nursery. And I kind of just thought, well, you know, it'd be worth trying it from the other
decision.
Point of view.
Tim, but no, but was it a decision? It was a choice. You had a choice. It wasn't
well, I did.
A,
yeah, and I was lucky to have a choice because I mean, my wife had been promoted at about the time that Charlie was born, so she wanted to go back to her career, and luckily she earns enough to pay the bills.
Okay, now here's the question I want to ask both of you: Do you had the choice, and you had the choice, right? Do you actually like doing it? Is there a difference that you actually find that you didn't like doing it and you do like doing it, or do you not like doing it and it is your duty? You know, because I mean, I don't think I would like doing it. That's I'd have to be honest.
I mean, I think you're right, and you are honest to say that. And there are some mums that don't like it either. There are some mums that aren't suited to the stay-at-home role, and there are some dads. But I don't think we should assume that just because you're a man and just because there are certain things you can't do. And they're but very, very limited. I don't think
Martin,
we can assume that dads aren't...
Yeah. You say, you know, old men aren't equipped, but then actually women are kind of thrown in at the deep end. You have your first baby,
I mean,
you've been a working woman. What's the difference?
Well, the difference is that women tend to have much better peer groups they can talk to about it. You know, women are much more open about their emotions with their friends. They go to birthing groups and, you know, so do the partners, but we tend to hook up with the blokes and we become friends with them or we go for a pint with them. But the actual nitty-gritty of motherhood, you know, mums excel at. And I think when I joined in the groups, the breastfeeding started in front of me, you know, my wife breastfed in public, I'm okay with all that. But there was one incident where I was basically asked to leave a group when a woman started breastfeeding. And I found that really kind of upsetting. Yeah. And I think that biologically, you know, kind of underline something that you can't get away from, and that is, you know, women know more about parenting
now,
than men.
Now, the other thing I've got to ask you is that I read, you said you feel it affected your sex life, that you felt emasculated, you didn't feel sexy.
Yeah, I think there's no surprise. I mean, housewives have known this for generations. You know, if you're minding toddlers all day, babies all day, you don't want to put a negligee on at 6 o'clock and start spraying perfume behind your ears. It's the same with men. It's like, you know, you're exhausted, you're shattered, you know, you feel like you want, you know, praise and recognition, but, you know, why should you? All you've been doing is managing the kids. You get argumentative about how much tomato sauce are allowed, about minutiae, pointless things.
You, has that changed your attitude to maybe when your partner stayed at home, when you came home and she wasn't in a negligee and she was argumentative and worn out and, you know...
Yes, point taken, Ruth, point taken. but has that
affected...
Personally,
I don't wear any negligee. Yes. All
Tim, has it affected the balance in your relationship with your wife?
I think you've got to... You know, when your wife comes home at six in the evening, in my case, it's not the case that she just assumes that I've been doing nothing more than staying at home looking after the kids. I mean, she does appreciate that it's a terrifically difficult job. It's the hardest job I've ever done.
There'll be a lot of men watching today and they will realise they are guilty of that same sin, of course,
It does happen and it's kind of inevitable, but I think you've got to make got to make an effort. You've got to go into it with your eyes wide open. From our point of view, it works very well because my wife has quality time when she does come home, because I run the house.
In short, should men give it a go or leave as is, leave to the natural order?
Absolutely. Have a go. Most men I talk to wish they had the opportunity to do it and regret not having done it earlier.
I'd say give it a whirl. It's very interesting, worthwhile to do, but don't expect to be any good at it. And if you're not any good at it, don't feel like a failure by saying so. You know, reach out to your partner, somebody, talk to somebody. Okay. Lucky on the end.
Martin, Tim, thank you both very much indeed for being so open about it. We're going to gauge your reaction to what they've had to say after the news. Don't go away.